Great to be here. Thank you.
Republican leaders are pushing back on claims that they knew how the alleged Christmas Day bomber was being interrogated. Obama's top counterterrorism chief, John Brennan, says all four knew that since the FBI was questioning the suspect, it meant that he had been Mirandized. But ranking Intelligence Committee member Pete Hoekstra, he says something else. He says no. His quote was, "I don't think Brennan is lying. I think what he is saying is that he just gave us some info, and based on that kind of info, we should have figured out something else. That's an unfair characterization." Cut me some slack, will you? I mean, I guess it's too much to expect that the ranking Republican on the Intelligence Committee to know basic protocol for gathering intelligence. For more, let's bring on our panel on this. Errol Lewis is a columnist for the New York Daily News and the host of the morning show on WWRL here in New York City. And Ernest Istook is a former Republican congressman and a distinguished fellow at the Heritage Foundation. Earl, the Democrats, how should they handle this criticism right now about Mirandizing terror suspects, criminals, whatever you want to call them? As the way this whole thing came down, it looks like a lot of Monday morning quarterbacking going on.
Well, it sure does. But I think the key is to go back to the principles. This is the same as in the healthcare debate. What is the principle? We believe in the rule of law. We support the use of the Constitution. We're not afraid to put our justice system out in front of the world and try these criminals and bring them to justice. And this notion that telling somebody that they have some rights, in other words, introducing them into the system, complete with their rights and responsibilities, and setting them on the path toward the system that has worked for centuries, the idea that this is some sign of weakness is the first problem. The notion that people would walk away from our own Constitution, our own legal principles, to me, it almost smacks of treason in a case like this. We have tried, and in the Southern District in New York, they have a 100% conviction record of trying very serious mm-hmm. terrorists. And I don't know why people think that that's somehow a problem, but there it is, and Democrats need to stand up and push back against it.
Well, I don't think they really are as much as they should be. You make a great point there. Errol, but now, Ernest, why don't the Republicans say, you know what, our intelligence people are just doing a great job because this Christmas Day alleged bomber is serving up all kinds of information, we got new leads. Instead, all we hear is the Republicans saying, well, they're secretive, and read him his rights, and that's not how you treat terrorists. Why can't the leadership of the Republicans, especially Mr. Hoekstra, say something positive about our intelligence people?
You know, part of the problem, Ed, we've lost a month after they Mirandized them, gave them the rights, and then it took a month to get them talking again. Remember, this is a reversal, of course, from the Obama administration. After the bombing, he said, I don't want to play the blame game. The problem is we dropped the ball. We didn't connect the dots. My security team didn't do it right. Now they're trying to say it's all the Republicans' fault because in a brief courtesy call that night, Christmas night, they didn't object in that particular call, even though, of course, they were objecting promptly and immediately.
Ernest, you
thereafter.
Were going to tell
this is just an attempt to manufacture.
You're telling our audience tonight, Ernest, that there is an attempted attack on the United States, and it's a courtesy call from the security people to the head of the intel people on the committees in Congress.
That's exactly what it was. If you look at those brief calls.
Go ahead.
Ed, that's the way those things work. You know, they're required to give some communication to the people. These are courtesy calls. They were not in-depth calls. Talk to the participants in it. It was not an in-depth call. It was just a superficial covering. To try to say that because these Republican members didn't jump in and stop them, when, of course, it was already water under the bridge, they'd already given them Miranda warnings, to try to say, therefore, it's their fault that they lost a month of information.
What a shame and what a scandalous shame it is to suggest that the first thing lawmakers should do is try and make sure that the law is not adhered to make sure that we create some unprotected space.
The first thing they should do is protect people from other plots that we thought might be going on right at that time.
The guy was giving up information. The guy was completely secure. He was giving up information. Why not start him
off? He gave it for 50 minutes, and then he shut up for a month.
I see. And so is the idea what, we should have tortured him a little bit? Would that have been a preferable? Is that what you want members of Congress to argue for?
We should have used protocols. we should not have used protocols that urged him to remain silent. We should have done everything possible that was legal to pull information
people,
out of
you know,
him.
People
we
have been
didn't
saying
know if there were other coordinated attacks that were underway at the time. Remember 9/11? Those were coordinated their line attacks.
Every day, all across the nation, horribly guilty people are informed of their right to remain silent. It doesn't stop people from being convicted.
But when you have a current
gentlemen,
threat,
good to have you with us tonight.
Law enforcement holds back and tries to remove the threat.
We'll do
Thanks,
it again,
guys.
Fellas. Thanks so much. Coming up, Toyota is in damage control mode with another recall. This time, the Prius is in trouble. U.S. automakers should be going for the jugular, I think. That's next in the playbook. Stay with us.